In this video, we're going to talk about short links and when to use those. They're also called pretty links, but we're going to talk about how to add those, use those, everything about short links. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. Now, you have probably experienced or seen short links. Let me show you how I use short links personally. If you've been to any of my videos, I might make reference to a link that I might have down below in the show notes, and this is that area right here with the show notes. And here's an example of a short link where when you click this link right here, you see it has my domain name, which is wpcrafter.com/, and then whatever I want it to be, and I can send you anywhere I want to when you click on this link. And these are called short links, and I'm sure you've seen short links before. You can actually generate short links with several online services. One of them is called Bitly. Actually, let me just show you Bitly's website right now. This is Bitly's website, and you can easily go here and create an account and create short links. And you can also do it via Google. Google has a short link creator service. WordPress itself has a short link creator service. Now, personally, I don't like to use Google short links, Bitly short links, or what was the other one? It doesn't matter. You know why? Because a lot of times those links are attributed to spammers. So there are literally email services where if you send a Bitly link in an email, that email is either going to go to the spam folder or be automatically deleted. So a lot of these commonly used link shortener services that are free on the internet, they're commonly just the service is polluted with spammers, and you can't trust those links. That's why it's never a good idea to use Bitly links or the Google shortener links, any of those links. And there is a really good solution, and you can integrate this right into your WordPress based website. Now, if you go over to WordPress's website, wordpress.org, click on plugins and do a search for the phrase pretty link, you're going to be able to see a variety of plugins that actually will allow you to do this with WordPress. Now, the funny thing is I call them pretty links. A lot of people call them pretty links, and there's actually, they're called pretty links for a reason. There's a plugin called Pretty Link. It's kind of like when you want a tissue to blow your nose or something like that. We commonly call them Kleenexes, but Kleenex is the name of the brand, not the name of the product. That's kind of like with pretty links. If you think of these shortened links, they're prettier links. Instead of having these very long links or something along those lines, you can have these pretty links. So there are a few in here. There's Pretty Link Lite, which by far is the number one in terms of usage. Another well-known one is Thirsty Affiliates right here. Let's see, there's so many different ones that try to do this, but I'm going to tell you which one I have always used and which one I currently use, and it's Pretty Link Lite. I have been using them. They've been around probably the longest. You can see they're on over 200,000 websites, Pretty Link Lite, and I have used this since, 2012. So we're talking 5 years I have counted on this plugin, and it has been perfect the whole time. But I'll give you some honesty here. About maybe 6 months ago, I was strongly considering not using them anymore because I kind of considered it as having been abandoned. They weren't really improving it. It was kind of outdated and all this kind of stuff. And I was literally looking at alternatives, and then bam, they released an update. They updated it. They updated the interface. They updated the code. They updated everything. And I was very blown away. Now, Pretty Link Lite, it says Lite because it is the Lite version, which means there's a paid version, and that's called Pretty Link Pro. Here's Pretty Link Pro's website. So they updated the plugin, but they didn't get around yet to updating the website. And let me just tell you, the developer of this is also the developer of a very popular, very successful membership plugin called MemberPress. So it's built by a rockstar WordPress developer. So here's Pretty Link Lite. Now, I actually have Pretty Link Pro. I started with Pretty Link Lite. Now I use Pretty Link Pro. But I'm going to be honest with you, all the features that come in Pretty Link Pro, they're not so crucial, especially if you're getting started out. They're not that crucial, but there are some nice things in it, like more reporting options and stuff like this. So anyways, let's just go ahead and do a quick test install. So I've got a test site here. I'm going to go to Plugins, Add New. I'm going to show you how to make your first PrettyLink. Do a search for PrettyLink and it will be the first result. Let's go ahead and click on install and then let's install it now. Let me go back to the pricing. I'll have a link down to PrettyLink's website. But when you click on the pricing tab right here, you can see it's $47 per year. They actually had a recent price increase. And I'm the first guy to tell you not to buy something if you really don't need it. I think you're going to be okay with PrettyLink Lite. Okay, so I'm not saying come here and buy this, but I do own it and it's been working out great. Okay, I've downloaded it. I'm going to go ahead and install it. And there it is. And so here's an upgrade to Pro. So then it's going to add this new option right here that's this PrettyLink. You can click on it. And then all you need to do in order to create one of these PrettyLinks, just go ahead and click on Add PrettyLink right here. And right here would be your target URL. So let's just send people to my website. Why not? Okay, WPCrafter.com. And so you could choose whatever you want to appear for the URL after your website name. So let's just make this say Adam. Okay, and then we could go ahead and give it a title if we want. And I'll just call this test. Okay, there we go. And then we have some advanced options here. And I usually like to make this a nofollow link, just like that. You can also group these links together. I always have the tracking enabled right here. Let's see what if it shows you anything for the pro options. Okay, yeah, it's just saying you don't have the pro version, so you're not going to get any of these pro options. Honestly, I don't even know if I use those pro options. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and click on create, and I've already received an error. That's because this needs to be a properly formatted URL. So let me just go back here, and we're talking the HTTPS and all that. So I just toss that in my clipboard. I'm going to go there, and I'm going to paste it in like that, and then now let's click on create. All right. Oh, one thing I overlooked was the different redirect options, and they're right here where it says redirection, and you can read up on these. There are more additional redirect options in the pro version. So we'll just go with 307 right there and go ahead and click on update again, even though we don't need to. Anyway, so here is our PrettyLink. And what I can do, you can see right here, it's the domain name slash and then what I put for that slug. So all we need to do is click on this little link here to copy it to the clipboard. And then I can go into a new tab, just this one right here, and paste it in so you can see I have it there, the domain name and Adam. And when I hit enter, it should go to my WP Crafter site just like that. And there it is. So it works. Now, what's cool is when I refresh this, the clicks should increase. And then I can click on this and see what it shows me. It shows me some reporting and we have an IP address here. We have a date and time stamp. We know exactly the link that was clicked on. And right here, if this was, say, a link on my YouTube video, it would say the link to where they clicked on this from. I'm explaining that. And you can see that this free version is very, very full featured and it works pretty good. Now, I think you get some advanced reporting options. Oh, I know what you could do with the paid version. You can do word replacements. So if you have a blog post and say this blog post is about Beaver Builder and you say the phrase Beaver Builder several times, well, you can have it automatically do keyword replacement. That's where you could type in Beaver Builder, and anytime Beaver Builder appears on that page, it'll make it a hyperlink that will take you to that link or whatever that PrettyLink is. That's actually a great feature and I use it a lot. So that's, I think, one of the pro features. There's probably a bunch more of pro features that are useful that I'm not bringing up right now. But if you just want a basic link shortening solution, this is ideal right off the bat. And yeah, here's the comparison of the two. So you can, okay, none of these are so crucial. Let's see. None of these are so crucial. Some of these links import, export. Here it is. Replace keywords in pages, posts, and custom post types. This is a feature that I actually do use. Oh, time-based redirects. So anyways, the point is You can come here and decide if you want the paid version of it or the free version. I think for most people, the free version is going to get you pretty much everything that you need. But once you start making more money with your website, you might want to invest back into some of these pro versions of these tools. That dynamic keyword replacement for me is an important feature. So if I'm typing out a blog post, I don't have to say, here's the link for Beaver Builder. I could just type Beaver Builder and it's going to change it and make it a hyperlink that is tracked. And I really like that. But if you just want this link shortener, then you are all set. And there's a lot of scenarios where you want to use the link shortener. Personally, for me, whether you realize this or not, if anyone that puts up a YouTube video puts a link in the description, if that link is not associated with your website, when someone clicks on it, YouTube first sends them to a warning page that says, warning, you know, you're leaving YouTube and we don't know what's going to happen. But if it's a link that's tied to your website address, you don't get that when you click on one of my links. So that's a lot of times when you click on my links, I'm not like an affiliate or anything like that. It's just because I want to make it a smoother process clicking out of my link and into wherever you want to go. So that is why I use them in my YouTube videos. But you absolutely should take advantage of pretty links and shortening your links. There's also, I think with that thirsty affiliate, they have a different link structure. So it's your website name slash, and then a lot of people make it say go slash, and then the link shortener. I don't like that because then I know I'm kind of clicking on someone's affiliate link or some kind of link where I don't know like where it's actually taking me. So that's another thing that I like about PrettyLink. It's literally my domain name slash and then whatever I want. So if you use a link shortener, I would love to hear which one you're using down below, but also add why you use that particular link shortener. I would love to hear about it in the comment section below.